Merry Christmas. And we've got a crack of a show tonight. Later on, we'll catch Keith Barron with his trousers down. Woo-hoo! Like that. But first, you all remember when we let people make their own music videos and they sang along to records by pop stars like Gary Glitter and Dolly Parton, but they didn't know we were watching them? Well, we had so many letters about the item that we went back to Blackpool and did it again. And this time, we got a real thriller for you. Here we are in Blackpool on the Golden Mile. And here is our legendary video booth. But tonight, everybody wants to be Michael Jackson. First was Keith Wilson. Then came Peter Cook. Wayne Shore and Keith Brown with Double Trouble. Finally, Les Peters. You recognize him now, but look at this. Liz is a lovely little mover. Brother Keith's a dead ringer. Go on, little Wayne, keep up with him.
Whoops. She told me you're...
And Peter. Just me. Go on, Wayne, get in the groove. Shake your funky thing. And let me introduce you to my favourite, Keith and Gwen. Take it away, guys. Do you like Duty Free?
Yes.
You do? Do you like Duty Free? Oh, I love it. It's one of my favourite programmes. And one of its stars, the lovely Gwen Taylor, helped us play a great practical joke on her co-star, Keith Barron. We organised for Gwen and Keith to take part in what Keith thought was a live TV link-up with an Australian telethon. With Gwen's help, we made up some incredible questions where all her answers were not only wrong, but were designed to shock Keith. Remember, we told him the programme was live, so how will Keith react when he hears Gwen giving some unbelievable answers? So here they are being placed in the studio. What Keith doesn't know is that hidden right behind him is our phony Australian TV presenter, actor Lionel Haft. Now remember, Gwen knows all the questions and her answers have been designed to catch Keith off guard.
Now, if you just join us on tonight's first ever 24-hour Australian telethon, the number to phone with your pledges is Sydney 98765. And remember, every little bit helps. Now, I hope we're now going to be able to go back live to London, where sitting in our studio, we should have Keith Barron and Gwen Taylor, the stars of the hugely popular comedy series Duty Free.
Hello.
Hello.
I'll be answering your questions, and with $100 for each question, and so keep on phoning in the pledges. Now, are you there, Gwen and Keith?
Hello. Yes,
hello.
How are you?
Hello,
fantastic
everybody.
To see you. Could you give us a little wave here?
Hello.
For
hello.
Fantastic to see you. I'm hearing the weather's a bit soldier's bowl around the old pins over there.
It's worse than that.
What's it like there?
Just horrible.
Well, I bet you wish you were here. Listen,
we do.
That's fantastic. We've had lots of calls. We've had lots of calls here about the series, and the first $100 pledge is from Jane Sanders. She'd like to know a bit more about the people behind the characters. You know, ladies first. Now, Gwen, Amy Pierce doesn't seem to have any outside interest. In real life, what are yours?
Well, I'm I suppose, really, my main hobby is restoring old furniture.
Yeah.
Just watch Keith's face as Gwen says she's a computer genius.
Taken over my life. I'm doing an Open University course on advanced computer systems analysis. And it's absolutely absorbent. It's a wonderful thing. You might have to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning, it's a bit hard when you're working.
Well, I'd have to get up a bit earlier than 6 o'clock to do computer system analysis. That's fantastic.
It's easy.
Go on, listen, Gwen, that's marvellous. I mean, you've obviously got a tremendous sense of self-achievement. Yes. How do you follow that, Keith?
Well, I don't do anything. I do the painting. It's all news to me that, you know, I didn't know anything about that at all, computers.
Well, listen, we've got a nice one here from Herbie Hanna of Kalgoorlie. Now, he wants to ask you, Gwen, but what about funny moments on or off
Keep
the screen?
Keep your eyes on Keith's face. Gwen's about to steal his favourite story. It's the one where he had to jump out of bed because he got cramped while filming a love scene.
Yes, I do know. It was when I was starting out in the business.
Yeah.
And I was doing a love scene in a film, you know, and I wasn't very sort of experienced, and I was in bed with this guy, and it was early in the morning, and I'd not really met him before, and I was, you know, it was a bit embarrassing when you do that sort of thing, and we were sort of getting on quite well, and the shot was going well, and suddenly he just leapt out of bed, screaming round the studio. I mean, absolute agony. The whole place was and nobody knew what was wrong. I thought it was me. I thought, what have I done? You know,
it was just
the most frightening thing in the world, in a way.
Yeah, well,
why did he jump out then?
What was the
cramp?
Cramp. That's very funny. Oh, wait a minute. Angela Stone of Grafton, New South Wales. Now, she's got a very personal question here for you, Gwen. As someone who knows Keith more intimately than anyone else, is there anything about Keith you think is outstanding? What I think Angela's on about, really, for $150. I think she wants to know about something physical, you know what I mean?
Well, look at him. He's pretty dishy, isn't he? I'm very lucky in my leading men. I like his hair, and I think his face is rather nice.
Yeah.
But Keith would want me to talk about his legs, because he's extremely proud of his legs, and any scene that we could have in Duty Free that had shorts on...
Well, here's a great opportunity for someone in the audience to pledge $200 to see Keith's legs. Come on, are they really spinning? Come on! Can you pledge $250? $250! Go on, Keith, go up, show us your beauties.
We still have
all the way down. Come on, man. The station here is offering $1,000, Keith, if you and Gwen will do a quick station promo with our mascot, JB.
Fine.
Certainly.
There we go. You got the hat there?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Wonderful.
That's it. Marvellous. Now, if you just... Yeah. Now, if you got the card there... Is the card on there? Can they see it all right? Now, if you'll just read the words on cue...
When now? Together?
After three. Yeah, okay. Together.
After three.
After three. One, two, three.
Watch out! Beadle's about. Wonderful. Is that all right? I didn't know you got this at home, Jeremy.
Perfect.
Oh, dear. We didn't just get me. What we've just done, Keith, is we've just got you, mate.
What do you mean?
Well, I have to tell you that this isn't a live link up in Australia at all. I have to tell you that all these stories that Craig's been nicking off you...
Come.
The cramp story.
Yes.
And the advanced computer analysis.
Yes.
Well, it's all a load of rubbish.
I don't believe it.
It was all just to see how you would react when you suddenly heard... stories about,
You mean I'm very good at lying?
You're very good at lying.
I'm taking my trousers off. Yeah.
Now I've got a special Christmas treat for you. Would you like to see a stunt that went wrong?
Yes!
I thought you might. Well, this is Christine, and she was meant to be the star of one of our most elaborate stunts, and she certainly was a star, but not quite in the way that we expected. Christine's the proud owner of a brand new red Ford Fiesta. And with her dad, we decided to have some fun by turning a car park into a travelling car showroom. With Christine's dad's help, we arranged for her to park exactly where we wanted her to. And here she comes with her dad to meet an important new business client. Next, it was time to separate Christine from her car. It was easy. We arranged for her to have a slap-up business lunch with her dad and the client. Off they go. Chauffeur-driven, no less. Then the fun began. First, we removed all the cars either side of hers, leaving it on its own. Meanwhile, the car park was being changed into a travelling showroom. And now the final twist. Enter a fleet of red Fiestas. We're all set. And here she comes. What's she gonna do? What's she gonna say?
Little, oh, I know. Joke,
what?
Joke.
You wanna buy a car?
This is Jeremy Beadle, isn't it?
During the break, I'm going to pull a cracker, but don't tell the wife. But I'll be back with something very, very special. Don't miss it. Thank you for all the hundreds of letters and ideas that you've sent them. Keep them coming in. But we've also had lots of requests for your favourite items featuring the real stars of this show, that's you. So what would you like to see again? Come on, tell me. What would you like? Oh, the hen... Trust you, yes, we understand why you want a hen party. That was a naughty stunt when we turned a husband into a male stripper at a hen party right in front of his unsuspecting wife. Pete's asking her to whip the mask off. Will she?
Got to!
Did you recognize him?
Another one. The wig one, okay. Yes, for some people who are meeting their boss for the first time, we arranged a truly hair-raising experience.
What kind of experience have you got?
Doing
cashier. Yes. I wonder if you could pass it to me.
No, I didn't move again.
Well, it's very valuable.
Well, I think we better leave it at that, Elaine.
Have to wear a wig, do I?
I love them. Do you want another one? What else do you want? What else? What? What do you want? What do you want? You want the port? Portakabin, yes. That's when a bargain hunter's high hopes came crashing down.
£1,748.
Right. 20, 40, 60.
The driver said he knew how to rig that thing. Does he work for you, this lorry driver, or what?
The chain's gone. No, the hook's gone.
Yeah, but the lorry driver rigged it up.
No, no, the chain's gone.
No, he did. He said to me, he said, I know how to do it. I've done flu handling these before.
No, hold on, sport. No,
he did, I promise you. No, he said it.
It's nothing to do with me.
But your lorry driver?
No, I've
been
tried.
But you arranged the delivery.
Yes. No, and let me explain, sport.
But you must have...
The chain's gone.
Yeah,
the
lorry driver rigged it up.
Yeah, but the chain's broken. Yeah. The crane chain.
Well, I hope you're well covered with insurance.
In bits. Your chain's gone.
I know it's gone.
Listen, I need
this by tomorrow.
Hang on.
Hold on. I'm going to put the customer coming tomorrow.
Where's your delivery driver? Your delivery driver strung that up for me.
I am hanging.
Hang on.
The delivery driver was the guy who told. Yeah, here he is. Yeah. Look, the driver strung that thing up to me.
You know, I was just lending a hand, mate. I was just lending a hand for Harry. Excuse me, mate.
Did you come
you Mr. Hall? Who's Mr. Hall? Is you Mr. Hall?
No, he's Mr. Hall.
Oh, can you just sign here, please, Mr. Hall?
It's his cabin.
No, wait a minute. Can you just sign here, please?
Hang on, let me...
No, can you just sign here?
Don't get me in case another chain falls down. Mr. Hall, come on.
Here.
Come on, I'm not insured for that sort of thing. Leave it alone. Come on.
Excuse me.
Watch out, Jeff. He's the owner of the shed.
What the hell? What's going on? Look.
No, hang on.
Have you seen what's happened? Have you seen what's happened to my business? I mean, how am I going to get 500 gnomes by tomorrow, eh? What do you mean?
With your driver, you're smart.
Are you Mr. Hall?
Yeah.
Will you sign there, please, and then you can say you've got these goods in good condition and I can get back to
one of my favourites, when Derek Hayes found his home had been taken over by the water board.
I think you're about right, though. Have you found it at all?
What's going on?
Is this it?
Yeah.
Oh, how do you do? Everything's going fine, as we said. It's going very well, actually, at the moment. We're just waiting for the van to move the furniture, really.
Bloody right, you're not.
What's going on? With the water board, we notified you about the exploratory work we were doing.
We never did.
We did. Don't go in there, sir. Don't go in there, sir. Please don't go in there, sir. You're not allowed in there, sir. No, if we've got water in there, sir. Yeah. Sorry.
If you don't get out of the way, I'll knock you out of the
bloody way. It's more than my job's worth, sir, because there's water in there and electricity. I'm sorry, you know what these services are like, is
it? If you wouldn't mind, this man has...
Before your gear out, let me in, because this is a load of old... whatever it is.
I'm sorry, I'm
giving you...
There's nothing to worry about. It's all under control.
Oh, let us know, good lad. You have not my written permission.
We don't need anything.
You do. I'm sorry. An Englishman's house is his crop.
Don't worry about that. It's all part of the excavation we're doing. It's all right, everything...
What are you doing?
Is everything going on all right?
Yeah, we've got a bit of a problem with a flood out there. Oh, dear. Where's the...
Don't go in there, sir, because of the electricity.
My husband is...
Oh, your husband is? Where is he?
He's over there.
What the hell's going on?
Who are you?
Hello. Oh, sh**.
Terrific. OK, what else? do you want? What else? Come on. The president's hijack. Now, yes, just to remind you, that's where we convinced an office manager that he'd been sworn in as an American Secret Service agent to protect President Ronald Reagan.
Would you please take the president? Okay. Major!
For PC Beadle to find out what's going on here.
There's nobody in there. They've gone. They took our car.
Just come to the car, sir. Leave that gun there. Come to the car.
Who are you? I'm going to lunch. The servants jumped out in front of us and commandeered my friend's car and took this guy out the back with him. Left me with a gun and this radio receiver and said they're going to Maidenhead.
Secret Service, sir.
Your briefcase, sir.
That's what the guy on the radio told me to check that the briefcase was in the car.
What guy, sir?
Two guys in Secret Service, American Secret Service, and one guy in an American General's, that uniform. We were just coming down the Marlow, the back road to Marlow Bottom, to go to a friend's house where my wife is, and he jumped out in the road with his hand up in the air, stopped the car, and said, "Excuse me, can you help us? Our car's broken down, we've got to get this guy to Maidenhead." And left me with this radio receiver, gave me a gun, swore me in as an American Secret Service agent. The friend from the car I worked with was driving me down there for lunch. They'd taken her and got in the car.
I see, sir. Right. You're a Secret Service agent,
sir.
You're not a Secret Service agent.
Look, shall we just get it straight? I work in High Wycombe, and I was going to lunch at a friend's house where my wife is, and we're going to have lunch.
So how do you do it normally, sir?
I work in Wycombe. I run a computer department in Wycombe.
Who are you in communication with there, sir?
Well, the guys in the car. One of them had one transmission.
Would you mind calling him up, sir?
Hello, this is Mr. Sanderson. Can you hear me? Over.
Yes, I can, Mr. Sanderson.
There is a gentleman with me at the moment. Can you assist him?
Who is it that's with you, Mr. Sanderson?
Can I explain who you are?
Of course you can.
He is a British policeman, sir.
And what would be his business with the president's car, Mr. Sanderson?
Well, he is wondering why I was stood in the road with a gun in my hand and this... Yeah, he understands who you are now.
If I try to explain, my name is Charlie Simple.
Weren't they all absolutely fantastic? Well, keep your ideas and letters rolling in. But until the next time, a very, very happy, a prosperous 1997 you all. And remember, wherever you are, whatever you're doing.